far better than he deserves.
You would say that, Adric. Your wife acts like a sow in a skirt.
My sweater rudder's a worthy woman, you coxcomb. But she's an excellent cook.
With a fine nose for truffles.
If Birsten does not return soon, wine will not be the only thing spilled upon his floors.
Now, gentlemen, everyone is fractious with this waiting. Now, gentlemen, everyone is fractious with this waiting. Let us be civil at least.
Muddy boot steps all over the floors. Ces Anglais sont des cochons.
Les Anglais.
You! Guards will come at one cry from me!
Sheathe your blade, lady. I'm Eivor of the Raven Clan, here at your husband's request.
Another Dane.
I am Estrid, wife of the Lord of Essex. As you may have heard, my lord is not at home.
I'm wary of rounding up Saxons. Is your husband stolen, drunk, or wayward?
He'll be stalking the woodlands today, hunting game and ignoring the vital affairs of Essex. One such affair is why we called for you.
If I can find him, I'll remind him of his duties.
Ah, such would be a miracle. His favorite haunt is southwest of here. The lavender fields there attract the prey, God help him.
With luck, he hasn't been eaten, but I'll return either way.
Patience is a godly virtue, Adred.
Even the saints were tired of waiting for Pierce to hang up his bow. Dear Estrid, we must discuss the affairs of this land, with or without you.
Itchy son, he's swinging a lick to me.
What do you see?
Hunting is a fine sport, but I hope the Elderman has not become the prey. No good comes from a camp this bloody. They were caught off guard as they supped. The remains of the hunting party. This one was savaged by a large animal. They were attacked by a beast. Something strong enough to kill the horse.
What the fuck?
So-called large prey left these tracks in the grass.
Look how big that fucking tar is.
I can only hope that Bjerstam still lives.
Spread your wings, Sunan.
Bjerstam?
Ready your weapon, or accept your fate as a feast for bears. Do not let them charge you.
Fought, friend. I would not have survived this ambush without you. You have my gratitude to stumble upon me in my moment of greatest peril. Perhaps you were godsend.
I'm Estrid Send. Your wife and the Thanes of Essex both want your balls on a blacksmith's anvil.
When do they not?
You could return and report that the savage claw took me. Poor Beerstan, his exit pursued by a bear.
And make the beast Lord of Essex in your stead.
No doubt my Estrid would prefer his velvet paws to my calloused hands. So, who are you? A sellsword?
I am Eivor of the Raven Clan. You hinted at an alliance for the loan of my unique talents.
S'blood, yes. Let us return to Colchester at once, and we'll speak more of the delicate matter on my mind. I'm glad you answered my summons. I did not expect such a skilled fighter.
It's good I came when I did. You lost many men on this hunt.
Good men, all. They will have the proper rights, and their families will be cared for.
Your people sacrificed much for your sport.
They did. There is no balm for my tortured heart.
Why did you ask me here?
Do you believe in true love, Eivor?
I have loved.
But have you truly? Has a longing burned in your breast, a sweet, lingering pain, paralyzing you with its sting?
There's pain enough in battle. I do not seek it out in love.
I long for it. The thrill of a fight softly won. My wife Estrid lacks fire. She is a fish out of water, cold and dead.
She showed great passion when I met her, keeping your thanes in check.
Oh, they love her, it is true. Some with too much devotion. And I have not been a good and attentive husband. I have always been a plucked goose in matters of love, and a piss-poor ruler to boot.
Strong must be the hand that steers the ship, Eston.
My hand would rather tug the catgut of a well-crafted bow, my eyes narrowing at the sight of prey.
Aye, a crown sits heavy on the head.
Then let us run wild and free in the woods as the wolves do. Live on our wits, prowl and stalk and feast.
You have a romantic way about you, Bisten.
Do not fret. My guards will not worry you when we are together.
You mismark me if you think I'm capable of worry. Have you built your city in the ruins of another?
No, these builders are lost to the annals of time. Far advanced of the Saxon hovels of Wattle and Daub, I have ambition to build a great palace myself, with mosaics and balmy courtyards.
What stops you?
That which stops all but the most creative minds. Coin, imagination, talent.
And your people? Is Essex happy?
That is a question I never really ponder. I suppose they are. I hope they are. Alfred believes I rule like a chickless hen, flapping and squawking over nothing but the farmer's dinner.
He interferes.
No, he disapproves. Is that not infinitely worse? But look, we are nearing my hall. I must face the wolves at my door before we discuss your favor to Essex, Eivor.
It may be I can speed your business along.
Ready to help me fend off the spears of their displeasure?
Let them speak their woes. I'll advise you if I can.
Who is this owl, Beirston, that twitters in your ear?
An advisor, nothing more. Here to help Essex navigate her brewing storms. Now, my dear brethren, Adred, perhaps you will start us off. What troubles you?
You're a disgrace, Beirston. Couldn't get a sow pissed in an alehouse. Alfred's men are crawling all over Essex.
King Alfred, yes. Though it is within his right, the constant presence of his men is certainly an issue.
Are they men or babes? If Alfred meddles in the affairs of Essex, send his men home in shrouds.
Ah, we should challenge his right to rule. Was not Essex once a thriving kingdom of its own? We should fight, yes, fight! And you, Wyatt, what do you say?
Your preparations for the Lammas Festival. How can you think of spending so much coin when your people are starving?
Often should one make an early meal, nor fasting come to the feast.
The feast, yes. The festival. This is not for full bellies, but to bless the loaf. Does that not bring us all good fortune? And Aldrich, do you yap like a she-hound as Adred does?
You know my thoughts, Bearston. The Feared. How can we give men to Alfred for his wars when our harvest suffers day by day?
Do they not defend your land? You'll need all the men you can muster to fight the coming wars.
The Danes are a great threat when provoked. Those we cannot ally with, we must fight or lose our lands. There. Have I not answered all your questions?
You are a stain on this shire, Bearstan. Useless.
Useless.
That's right. Yet still you haunt my hall. Be gone. I haven't time for your squabbling. That ceased their prattling. A fine outcome, Eivor. The very soul of balance.
A firm hand is all you need, Bearston. Whether on your hunting bow or on your helm.
All this talk of hunting makes me long for the woods.
Your wife awaits, Bearston. Aren't you worried some other man will drench your sheet with his sweat?
Ha! She does as she must. As do I. But you will discover this soon enough.
You have done the impossible, Dane. Returned my errant gander to his coop.
My pettish love. Such a stormy countenance clouds the sun of my return.
Your thanes drank the ale the abbot gifted us. All of it.
Now that is a tragedy my heart will not easily overcome.
If he looked at me with the same affection he shows for hunting deer, our marriage might have survived.
I notice your love has gone sour. Was it fresher than this?
There is so little difference between love and hate. It's difficult to say where the sourness comes from.
So, what do you need of me?
Our affairs are more of heart than of state, Eivor. What little passion there was between us faded into bickering long ago.
We would have our freedom, Eivor. I from my wife, and my wife from Essex.
I'm too sharp a weapon for so soft a task. Why not part and be done with it?
Oh, were I a Dane, and divorce as simple as a slit throat. But it's not so easy as that.
Does your god not allow husband and wife to part?
Our god? Our king? There is much standing in the way of a joyous uncoupling. Ours was an arranged marriage, a political need, and not easily broken.
Explain yourselves, clear and plain, and I will do it. The poetry here is mind mud.
We had a plan, a simple plan. A woman lost and a woman found.
Some time ago, we paid a Dane to kidnap me and ferry me safely to Francia. As you can see, he did not deliver.
He was certainly thorough in other regards.
Some Norse can be quick to take coin and slow to earn it. If I give my word, it is not broken.
Could we try the kidnap again? Much of the planning is done. It would only take a more trustworthy overseer.
It should be a bold venture if we do. Loud and brash and seen by all.
During our Lammas festival, merry peasants and guards with wandering eyes.
Your return to Francia would need a swift ship, with a captain ready to leave England.
We could ask him.
I would have thought his steed and seamen spent.
Come find me in the market, Eivor. Our unwelcome guests require food and ale to soften their anger.
My wife is a gracious and attentive host, Eivor. The only thing that keeps my braying thanes at bay.
And the woman found?
A darling Maybud, Ulvida, my childhood sweetheart. I left her 20 years ago in Molden to marry my prickled pear.
20 years? Can an ember so cold be reignited?
We can hope. You must fan the flame. Find her, bring her to my lakeside cottage, and light a bonfire there. I will know to come. I believe she lived in the last house in Molden. A small, sweet place where fond memories were made.
I will do as you both ask, and ask Freya for success in this love game.
Good luck in your endeavors, Eivor. I pray you find my Alvida with a fair face and a yearning heart.
Now, should I look for Alvida first, or meet with Estrid at the marketplace?